From CBS News, a new TikTok challenge involves teens recording themselves sliding a penny behind a phone charger that is partially plugged into an electrical outlet. CBS, this is not a new viral challenge. This is something like two kids in Massachusetts did, and now every local news site is trying to make it seem like it's some big thing. One of my major fears in life is that I think I'm gonna lose touch. I think I'm already losing touch with the younger people. But when I actually do, I hope I don't act like this, where I think every single, like, strange event that kids do is tied to a strange thing that they're into. I really hope I'm not that old person, but I have a feeling that that's an inevitability that all humans will eventually hate the younger generation. Oh my god, they blocked me because I wanted a baseball cap instead of a snapback. No, we blocked you because you kept crying about wanting a baseball cap every time we posted, to the point you were even crying to us through DMs as well as cursing about wanting them. And after you started DMing our designers as well, there is a thing as having some dignity and respect towards others. You should check out what that means. The only way you can cry on, like, DMs and Instagram is if you do the little voice function thing. Imagine holding that thing down and crying, like, I want a hat! Please give me a free hat! Trash, don't waste your time on this pay to win, and screw you if you don't pay any money. Non-stop ads, I even spent money on it. You think that they would take away ads after that? Don't waste your time. It's fun if you didn't have emeralds and ads. You ruined your own game. Shame on you. This isn't true! We never show ads if you yourself don't want to watch them, unlike many other games. Yes, you can advance faster by watching ads, and if you're willing to support the developers, but you can still beat the game without seeing a single ad and without spending money. I wish more games were like that. It seems like a lot of games, especially mobile games, are very much pay to win. It's almost like you have to drop 50 bucks on the emeralds or coins or whatever in-game currency just so you can advance and get all the cool stuff in a game, which is ridiculous. It's awful stuff. It's nice to see that this developer is getting it. That's a tat a 17-year-old designed, and it's a good tat in my opinion. You can clearly see what it is from far away, and the lines are really clean. A tat you designed at 17? That's stupid. A quick Google search proved that wrong. Wow, it took 6 posts for us to get to someone who's stealing people's art. Why do people like to do this? Why do people go out of their way to just say, "Ooh, this is mine! I drew this!" It takes nothing time, nothing effort to prove you wrong. Seriously. And when you're caught, what can you say? Oh, yeah, I am a bad artist, or I don't have any skill, and I was just stealing ideas from people. My girlfriend and I went there today and the food sucked, and the beer wasn't much better. The owner had an attitude. My girlfriend and I couldn't drink the beer because it was too heavy and it was warm.
Hey, wait, pause.
Drinking beer that's too heavy, so it's not canned beer. Someone gave you, like, the little pitcher glass, and you can't pick that up? What are you, anemic? And the owner wouldn't take it off the bill. Do not go here. You're better off going to a different restaurant. Okay, Hercules, sorry about your butthurt experience at our restaurant. We remember you very well, and can't understand why you would visit a brewery if you only like light beers. You ordered 2 flights of beers, 10 to 4 ounce samples of dark beer, and then tried them all, then bring them back up to the counter and tell the bartender that you don't like heavy beer. As for the beer being warm, that does not add up, as all 13 taps come from the same cold room, and we had no other patrons complain about warm beer ever in 5 years of business in the craft beer industry. As for the food being sucky, well then why did you eat all of it and then leave a $15 tip? If it was as bad as you say, you would have returned it, right? Please stick to practice beer, i.e. Bud Light, Coors, Schick Ultra, you know. You should be fine. Craft breweries are not for you, Chief. Hey guys, take a look at my art. I'm gonna post it on Reddit and say it's my art. Uh-oh, someone called me out. Are you sure you drew this? This was posted on DeviantArt a while ago. Just checking if it was actually you or not. Spoiler alert, it wasn't. OP went into detail about how this guy simply just copied and pasted the image from DeviantArt right onto Reddit, trying to get all of that karma. Baby, if you want to have sex with me, then you need to get on live. I'm giving you a profile where you can join me. Bruh, you're a bot. Baby, I'm not a bot. Baby, my site is free. You can just submit your email and search my username and find me. And I'ma stop you there. Literally no human being would have me go through the shady website just to meet them. I know exactly what's going to happen. I'm going to follow the link you gave me, then I would put my credit card info, then it would steal it and not give me access to seeing you. After that, you would just ghost me. I didn't know there were sex bots on Snapchat. That just brings me back to Kik and how every other message would be a girl trying to make me go on their, you know, sketchy porn website. But I didn't know that's on Snapchat. Personally, I don't use Snapchat a lot, so I wouldn't have known anyway. But that's crazy. That's something. They're everywhere. But get ready for this. Those who don't know, this is going to date the Panda Daddy a little bit. But way back in my beginning times of gaming, I used to use this thing called Skype. A lot of people don't use that anymore because it's just dead. Every other message I would get on Skype, because they wouldn't call you because you couldn't call a bot, but they would all be named Laney, and every single one of them would make me try to go on their little live chat websites. I just remembered that now. I'm like, yep. I vividly remember anytime I'm online playing Minecraft with the boys at the time, I would always get another message from Laney trying to make me go on her website. Good times, good times. Yo, check out this digital art my friend made. Ooh, that's nice digital art right there. Too bad you stole it! Yeah, somehow I don't believe your friend painted the art for Sword and Shield booster packs. I knew it looked a little familiar. I didn't know it was box art or it was just a screenshot from the game, but no, I remember seeing this on a commercial. It is the photo they used for Sword and Shield booster packs. Quick aside, I don't know if this is compatible with the channel, but I'm just gonna ask anyway. I have a lot of just Pokemon stuff that I do on the side. If you want me to ever do pack openings or like elite box openings or whatever, just look at my card collection at any time. You just want a video like that, let me know in the comments down below. It's really stupid. It's just a little hobby of mine that I really need to outgrow because I am a grown person, but I still love Pokemon TCG. If you want to see that, just let me know in the comments down below. I was supposed to buy Harry Potter scarf and glove for my daughter, but I didn't due to the very unfriendly staff in the shop. It might be just a private collection, not for sale. You can't touch the collection, even though there was no sign like no touch. If you place a sharp wand with a 14 plus age sticker on it in the hands of a small child while sitting in a buggy and let them wave around and chew on it, I don't really feel sorry at all. I asked you as a parent not to touch it and prevent injuries. You might find that is rude, but as a visitor to my country, you should be aware that we have different habits and rules. Placing a sharp, fragile object in the hands of a toddler is a sign of bad education. You should be thanking me that after I looked after your child for you. Hi, I'm Mia.
Hi, Mia. You're so fluffy and cute. Look at you. Just adorable.
Aw, yeah, I love this cat too, but I gotta call you out on this, OP. This picture was stolen from the internet on Instagram. I recognized this picture as soon as I saw it. I love the appreciation of this beautiful cat, but her name's not Mia. The original pic was posted on Pumpkin's Instagram on October 4th, 2016. Why you gotta rain on my man's parade? He only wants clout and karma. Let him have it. Don't correct him and tell him to stop stealing stuff from the internet. Let him do his thievery so that he can feel important for a day. Beware, guys. Where I went last night at 1800, three older guys at the bar started buying me shots. Absinthe. Then I tried to leave and settle my bill, and the bartender wanted to charge me for all the drinks the old men had. One of the old men, bald-headed, claimed to be Israeli/Hungarian, has bad teeth. Started beating me because I didn't want to pay for their drinks. I should say I was really drunk at this time and I didn't fight back. The bald man then took my wallet with 2,500 bucks in it and my watch that was kicked out of the place. All the thieves in that place. Luckily, I managed to go to my hotel safely. Heaven ruins my Prague experience. I will not come back to Czechia. Wow, that truly sounds awful. I mean, I couldn't imagine someone beating me up and robbing me just because I didn't buy their drinks. But thank goodness you weren't lying. I'm sorry for this bad experience at my club, but you were really drunk and you probably don't remember your night correctly. But you didn't write the truth. Men on the bar order drinks for you. This is true, but you ordered drinks for them too. And on the end of your visit, you have no money to pay your bill. Bartender didn't want to charge you for all the drinks, just for the drinks you ordered. Nobody took your wallet, your watches, and nobody kicked you out of the club. You left your watches on the bar, like the deposit and promise. You will come tomorrow to pay your bill. But it didn't happen. I'm very sorry if you lost your money in the club. Next time, better tell it to the bartender, or try to choose your friends better, or don't drink so much with strangers. Otherwise, don't hesitate to stop in the club for your watches. See you. Hey, today's my birthday. Can I get a reply, please? So you were born twice in the same week, huh? This guy is just starved of attention. Imagine doing that, like, oh, FC Barcelona, could you please shout me out one more time? Because no one else cares. Modeling one of my mom's wigs for her business. Perhaps I should start charging. This person's profile is entirely built from stolen photos of me. I asked politely if they could stop, but they won't engage in conversation with me. Please report. Update. Twitter decided that it wasn't breaking any rules when I reported it. That's literally my face! So I'm a handicapped climber, who started to learn to climb in earnest after being inspired by the Tomb Raider video games. First post here. Wow, that's amazing, being a handicapped climber, doing something that I would never do with less ability? That's amazing. Good thing that you aren't lying. Update. OP is a fraud. This woman actually in these posts tells me that she doesn't even know what Reddit is and is very creeped out and uncomfortable. Hey folks, these photos actually belong to a friend of mine. I'm 99% sure this is not her account. She's a French paraclimber and a world champion, whose parents taught her how to climb, not inspired by Laura Croft. She lives in France, not Australia, and this is pretty fucked up as I see OP has also shared other photos from my friend's IG pretending to be her. I baked my pizza upside down after putting olives on the wrong side. Don't smoke weed and bake, guys. You had to cook the pizza normally, melting all the shredded cheese so that it didn't fall instantly to the bottom of the oven. Then flip it upside down to add all the olives. It seems really damn unlikely that this was accidental. Could you imagine burning cheese and ruining the grates of your oven for clout? I couldn't imagine doing that. I am not that thirsty for people to think I'm really funny to ruin something of mine that I need to use on a daily basis. See what happens when you stay on your grind. Bruh, did your door hit the gym too? Damn, her ass so fat, it's warping space-time! Meet Whiplash, introduced in Doom Eternal! This slithering, chain-lashing foe is the series' first female demon. Hits PS4 March 20th. Wait, hold up, this isn't even remotely true. Not only are the Summoner and Spider Mastermind female, Doom 3 had several female demons. Why are you lying about this? Ah, you naive soul. This isn't about the game, it isn't about demons, it's about wokeness. They just want to say that the first female anything is in their game so they can get that blue-haired crowd to spend some money. Hey, so I've been subbed to you for my whole treatment of cancer, and I watched your vids to keep me distracted. All I want is pewds to notice me. Hey, you lying sack of shit, reverse image search will show you that this image with a near exact description on r/YUB in late October last year from the bottom of my heart. Fuck you. This is so lame. Most likely this picture was taken off of Google and this child's being used to try to get, I guess, clout or something, or just someone to notice them. Why are you going to different creators' subreddits to try to get attention from them this way? This is awful. I've had sex 500 times. Ask me anything. Yeah, your profile doesn't check out, Chief. Yeah, on another post 19 days ago, you said you finally get to have sex. If it was truly your first time, in order to have sex 500 times, you would have to have sex at least 26 times per day. Assuming a healthy 8 hours of sleep per day, you would have to have sex every 36 minutes in order to reach this goal. I'm gonna call bullshit on this one, Chief. What's up, everybody? It's your boy, Ailurus, aka Panda Daddy, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. And if you did, let me know in the comments down below. And leave a like if you liked the video. And if you're new to my channel, go ahead and subscribe, fam. What you doing watching videos and not subscribing? And if you don't, make sure you hit that bell so you get these notifications every time. Seriously, take a look at this picture. Make sure you click that bell so you can get these notifications. If you want to see my content, make sure the bell looks like this. I greatly appreciate it. A lot of you guys requested this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want more Quit Your Bullshit, let me know in the comments down below. If you want to request any other Reddit content, let me know in the comments down below. Go ahead and go to the Patreon if you want to request any horror stories content, because you're gonna get some of that this week. I've been working hard on a really good old mystery, so I hope you guys are excited for that. The Patreon people, you should be able to get your horror stories content a little bit earlier, like usual, so you have nothing to worry about that. Speaking of the Patreon, thank you to Taki, Bunny Boo, Dustin, Canned Egg Plant, Kyle, and Hosmar. Thank you so much for your support. It is greatly appreciated. And if you want to help support the channel, there's two links in the description, one to my merch store and one to my Patreon. Both funds go directly into the channel so we can maintain what's happening here. And as always, stay zesty.